who was in the lab, used electricity to wake it up. It immediately clung to his hand, who was afraid and wanted to lift his hand, but the monster pulled Who's arm tightly. He did not know this monster had such great power. Immediately a scream rang out. Who pulled his hand out? All his right hand's bones was broken. He fainted because of the pain. Then, the monster used the stun gun, pierced the glove, successfully escaped from the experiment box. What the negligent people. This alien creature was so smart. Soon after, it entered the guinea pig's experimental cage, carefully probing the mouse, but was bitten. So it curled up the mouse tightly, digesting it all in a minute. Seeing such a ferocious monster, Rory quickly went into the lab to save Who. But the monster found out Rory had not come out, it jumped on his leg. The outside just closed the door. After that, Rory used the high heat of the Arxy candle to chase the monster away, then sprayed it with fire again, but this monster was extremely agile. It could hide miraculously fast. Soon after, the fuel was exhausted, and Rory was no longer intimidating it. So the monster jumped onto Rory's face, got into his mouth completely, and ate up Rory's viscera. Immediately he spat out a heap of blood, then his body was gradually sucked clean, not a bit more. When the monster came out of Rory's body, it became bigger. Then, it followed the flow of air to the water injection hole. The staff quickly closed the drain cap, but this monster was very smart. It got into the drain to go inside. The astronaut was fixing the spaceship, when he opened the device, the monster burst out from there, clinging to the travel suit. It clung tightly to the astronaut's leg. She slowly crawled past the doorway, but a few drops of coolant had appeared in her hat. The monster damaged the traveling suit's cooling system. She slowly crawled up, she cut off her seatbelt and jumped. When she flied by, she was lying on a railing. At this point, the coolant was about to fill the helmet. She held her breath, and had difficulty in crawling. Finally, she crawled to the spaceship's door. But the monster on her body was fluttering. She knew that it was impossible for monsters to enter spaceships. So she locked the door, and flew out with the monster into the air. But the monster sensed the danger, crawling over the astronaut's legs, and clinging to the spacecraft. Then, the monster tried to enter from this thruster. At this time, they also thought of a way to kill monster. After the monster got inside the thrusters, they started the spacecraft, and burned it to death. But the monster was cunning, not able to kill it, but also wasted a lot of the spacecraft's fuel. If the fuel quickly was depleted, they would have no way to go back to Earth. If the fire was not turned on, the monster would enter the spaceship. It was difficult to choose. They came up with a way. They lured the monster into a closed space. Then, they released all the oxygen in it to put the monster to sleep. But when everyone was ready, Who began to faint. The collie quickly took off Who's clothes. At this time, the monster was wrapped on him. It turned out that the monster was soon brought in by Who. Who like- Compartment. They closed the door and let out all the air from it. But unfortunately, an augmented machine successfully hooked up to their space station. But it was not to save them, to destroy all the aliens that had invaded the Earth. They wanted to push this space away. But the man in the capsule did not know. He thought the aid was coming, so he quickly opened the door that locked the monster. Colleagues quickly came to save him, but it was too late. There was a problem with the space station that caused a fan blade to break. The propeller quickly collided with the space station, and caused the space collision to crumble. Fortunately, their space station was not stabbed. The burning material had been exhausted. There was no way to go to the Earth. At this moment, spaceship was falling towards the Earth. Only 39 minutes to the great atmosphere. The two of them knew it was impossible for monster to enter the Earth. Otherwise humans would be in distress. So David decided to lure the monster into the lifeboat, let the monster fly with him into space, and Mira sat in another spaceship to return to Earth. David initiatively went outside, used the emitting heat, attracted monsters to him. Mira successfully returned to Earth. The capsule quickly flew back to Earth, eventually falling to the surface of the sea. At this time, fishermen were curious. They saw that David was held firmly by many arms. David shouted not to open the door, but the two fishermen did not hear, and opened the door. On the other hand, the mirror's cabin system had a problem, flight towards endless space. The ending of the movie was a vast expanse of space that we didn't expect to see. This foreshadows an upcoming Earth attack.